Hello everyone, we will study how to find the inverse of matrix by column transformation. Let us see please. For this I am considering one example. A is equal to 3, 6, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5, 2. Let us see please, we have one matrix. I have to find the inverse of this matrix using column transformation. Sometimes this question will ask in board examination. That's why it is necessary to know. So that I am teaching this concept by using column transformation. Solution. First we write given matrix. A is equal to 3, 6, 2, 1, 2, 1. 2, 5, 2. And now to check whether this matrix has inverse or not, we need to find its determinant. 3, 1, 2 first column, 6, 2, 5, 2, 1, 2. It is equal to 3 into 4 minus 5 minus 6 into 2 minus 2 plus 2 into 5 minus 4. It is equal to 3 into minus 1 minus 6 into 0 plus 2 into 1. It is minus 3 minus 0 plus 2. It becomes minus 1. We get determinant of A is equal to minus 1. And we can write determinant of A not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse A exists. It means that determinant of the matrix is minus 1, which is not equal to 0. It means the matrix is non-singular and it is invertible, so that we can write its inverse exists. Now, it is clear that inverse of the matrix exists. Let us see how to find its inverse by column transformation. During column transformation, we can use the definition. Now, by definition, A inverse into A is equal to I. A inverse into A is equal to I. Now, keeping this A inverse as it is, we can write A 3, 6, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5, 2 equal to I. It is I 3, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. And when you are using column transformation for inverse, we need to convert this matrix into identity matrix. To convert this matrix into identity matrix, we have the pattern. Keep in your mind this pattern. For 3 by 3 matrix, we can use this pattern. First bring 1 in this place. Then have to go to this place, getting 0 here. Getting 0 here. And then come here, bring 1. Go here, bring 0. Come again here, bring 0. Go here, bring 1, come here, bring 0, come here, bring 0. In this way, in this pattern, we can bring this matrix into identity matrix. After bringing this matrix into identity matrix, at the same time, there will be change in arrays. At that time, this arrays should be your inverse. Let us see please. I have to bring first one in this place using column transformation. If you observe first column and third column, it is clear that we have difference of 1 between them, so that we can use the operation C1 minus C3. Let us see please. If we use C1 minus C3, we get 3 minus 2, 1 and that is required there. C1 minus C3, A inverse. It is equal to 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1 becomes 0. 2 minus 2 becomes 0. 6, 2, 5 as it is. 2, 1, 2 as it is. 1 minus 0 is 1. 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 1, 1. Minus 1, 0, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. Got it? Let us see please. Now, in order to make this place and this place 0, we use the formula C2 minus 6C1. And C3 minus 2C1. A inverse is equal to keeping C1 as it is 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 1. C2 minus 6C1. 6 minus 6 becomes 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. 5 minus 0 is 5. and 0 minus 6 becomes minus 6, 1 minus 0 becomes 1, 0 plus minus minus plus becomes 6, and then C3 minus 2 C1 are to change the third column. C2 minus 2 is 0, which 2 minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 0 is 1, 2 minus 0 is 2. And then C3 minus 2, C1, 0 minus 2, minus 2, 0 minus 0, 0, 1 plus 2, it becomes 3. Okay? That is C3. I want to get in this place 1, so that I can use C2 minus C3. C2 minus C3. A inverse as it is, it is equal to, let us see please, C2 minus C3. 1, 0, 0 as it is. C2 minus C3, 0 minus 0, 0. 2 minus 2, C2 minus C3 only. 2 minus 1 is 1. 5 minus 2 is 3. 0, 1, 2 as it is. C2 minus C3. First column as it is, minus 6 plus 2 it becomes minus 4. And 1 minus 0 it becomes 1. 6 minus 3 is 3. And last column keeping as it is. Now, we have brought here 1 and we get already 0 here. Now we need to get in this place 0. For this we can use the operation C3 minus C2. Let us see this. C3 minus C2 gives A inverse. It is equal to C3 minus C2. 1, 0, 0 as it is. 0, 1, 3 as it is. C3 minus C2. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 1 becomes 0. 2 minus 3 becomes minus 1. 1, 0, minus 1. Minus 4, 1, 3. Minus 2 plus 4 becomes 2. 0 minus 1 becomes minus 1. 3 minus 3 becomes 0. Now, the next step. Now I have brought here 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. I need to go here and I want to bring in this place 1 so that minus of C3 gives. Minus of C3 gives A inverse. 1, 0, 0 as it is. 0, 1, 3 as it is. Multiply this column by minus 1. 0, 0, 1. It is equal to 1, 0, minus 1, minus 4, 1, 3. And minus 2, 1, 0. We have multiplied last column by negative sign. Now next. After getting 1 here, we need to bring here 0. For this, we are using C2 minus 3C3. If we multiply column third by 3 and if we subtract second column and third column, we get 0 here. A inverse. It is equal to the matrix. C2 minus 3C3, for this first column, no change. 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, 3 minus 3, 0, 0, 0, 1 as it is. C2 minus 3, C3, 1, 0, minus 1 as it is. Minus 4 plus 6, it becomes 2. C2 minus minus plus 6, okay. 1 minus 3 becomes minus 2, 3 minus 0 becomes 3, minus 2, 1, 0. Now, this matrix is identity matrix. We can write A inverse into I. Is equal to 1, 2, minus 2, 0, minus 2, 1, minus 1, 3, 0. Now here A inverse into I identity law, we get only A inverse is equal to 1, 0, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 2, 1, 0. Reason is identity law. This is the method to find the inverse by column transformation. Thank you.